The reason for the baptism is for you to be a witness unto him. Now, what does it mean to be a witness? To witness unto him means to prove whatever he said true on this earth. If he said that he heals the sick, he heals the sick. If he says that he gives us power and authority, he gives us power and authority. If he says that he delivers, he delivers. The Holy Spirit baptism gives us power to prove that. Now, if you're not baptized in the Holy Spirit, one of the reasons you're having so much difficulty overcoming is because of lack of power. He tells us that we'll receive power. You don't have the power unless you have the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now, who's the baptizer? Jesus. Jesus is the baptizer. The evidence of the baptism is speaking in tongues and prophesying and working miracles and healings and so on. Every person who believes in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, this is who gets the baptism. And that's found in Ephesians 5, verses 17 through 18. You can go back and read that. And John 7, verse 39. John 1, verses 12 and 13. This is where, and I'm giving you the scriptures so that way you can go back and study. The Holy Spirit moves in on the inside of us, and we are truly made a new creation and are now sons of God. So speaking in tongues, this is a gift, a divine encouragement as the Spirit gives us utterance to give to other people, to people. Praying in the Spirit or praying in the Holy Spirit, 1 Corinthians 14, verse 2, for he who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men, but to God, for no one understands him. However, in the Spirit, he speaks mysteries. When we are speaking in tongues, when we're praying in the Holy Spirit, we are speaking the mysteries of God. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 14 and 16 through 18, for if I pray in a tongue, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. Otherwise, if you bless with the Spirit, how will he who occupies the place of the uninformed say amen at your giving of thanks, since he does not understand what you are saying? For you indeed give thanks well, but the other is not edified. I thank God I speak in tongues more than you all. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 39. Therefore, brethren, desire earnestly to prophesy and do not forbid to speak with tongues. Ephesians 6, verse 18. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to the end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. It builds us up. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 4. He who speaks in a tongue edifies himself, but he who prophesies edifies the church. Jude 1, verse 20. But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a comforter. Jesus called him a comforter. I've seen a lot of people that claim to have the baptism of the Holy Spirit, but yet they're running around, knocking people over, hanging from chandelier. They're acting nuts. Yet they claim they have the comforter. The Holy Spirit is a comforter, and a comforter calms. The Greek word comforter is paraklete, which means someone who comes alongside to make sure the job is done. Isn't that a great job? You go preaching, Jesus is the healer, the Holy Spirit comes alongside and says, I'm proving this to be true. The Bible says the Holy Spirit is a teacher, he's a guide. So if he's a guide, he can only lead those willing to be led. Some people want the benefits of the Holy Spirit, but they don't want the leadership of the Holy Spirit. In order to follow a guide, we have to submit to them. In order to follow the Holy Spirit, our guide, we have to submit to him. The Holy Spirit is a guide. He's not a feeling that comes on you and makes you do things that you cannot control. Looking back at Acts 1 verse 8, the word power is referred to here as dunamis power. The word dunamis in Greek means dynamite. You shall receive dunamis, Jesus says. Not authority, dunamis. John 1 verse 12, but as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Now the word power in this verse in the Greek does not mean dunamis, it means authority. That means you have authority as a believer to say, I am a child of God. But in Acts 1 verse 8, the word power is dunamis, explosive, hurricane, tornado power. The church is to be the most explosive instrument on this earth that God is working through. Not the church building. The church, with a capital C, should be the most explosive power on this earth. The church is supposed to be the church with a small C. It's supposed to be a healing center. We should be putting hospitals out of business. I love the way Peter did it. He walked through the streets. 2 days after Pentecost, he went walking down the road and his shadow fell and they were healed and they were raised to life. I can imagine, can you just imagine the doctors nowadays if we walked through the streets and our shadow fell on people and they were healed and came back to life? Could you imagine the complaints that the hospitals and the doctors would start filing against us? The baptism of the Holy Spirit is a power release. Let's look at the nature of dynamite. So what is dynamite? Dynamite is potential power. A stick of dynamite is filled with power, but it is powerless unless you light it and it explodes. And many Christians are the same exact way. The Holy Spirit is dynamite. And the baptism of the Holy Spirit is when you put that flame to that dynamite and he explodes and releases power. Power's not effective unless it's released. You're not effective if you're staying sitting in the comfort of your own home, constantly never doing what the Lord is asking you to do. The power needs to be released. So you can brag all day long and say that you have the Holy Spirit and that you are Christian, but that doesn't mean that you're being exploded. That doesn't mean that you're releasing power. That doesn't mean that you're actually being an influence on others, on other disciples, and that things are being changed and you're rebuking the devil and keeping him under your feet. You bragging does not mean anything. It's when we see the release of power. You need the baptism of the Holy Spirit to live the abundant life that Christ has told us that we would live here on earth. You need the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Jesus said in Mark chapter 16, and those that believe in me, they shall lay hands on the sick. They shall cast out demons. They shall speak with new tongues. And whatever they drink that is harmful, it shall not hurt them. The baptism of the Holy Spirit is to make sure that things are getting done, that God's will is getting done. You need power to move the sickness, to cast out the demons. You need power.